You've done that, what? You put your computer on this thing.
Now it has come. Yeah.
Are we live? I think we're live. Yes, we are live. Okay, guys, thank you so much for joining us on another episode of 420 Grams. So we didn't come in the last episode, but now we're here back again. And we're coming after the Goa versus Persepolis game. A game that finished last night, Persepolis winning 4-0 in that game. Joining us on the show are Renedi Singh, former India captain, Jaideep Basu, and Siddhant Ani. Renedi bhai, I'll start with you. Firstly, I just hope everyone is safe and sound. Bad scene outside. And bhai, please take care of yourself, take care of your family. And abhi na time ye nahi hai relax hone ka. Abhi time hai ekjut hoke, ghar mein baith ke. चुपचाप वेट करने का बस और कुछ कर नहीं सकते आप सच में बताऊं तो लेट्स गेट टू द गेम रेंडी भाई 4-0 ऑन द नाइट डोंट वांट टू टॉक सो मच अबाउट द रिजल्ट ए ही मेड 5 चेंजेस एंड यू कुड अंडरस्टैंड व्हाई ही मेड द 5 चेंजेस बिकॉज़ ही सेड यू नो इफ आई एम प्लेइंग 6 गेम्स इन द स्पेस ऑफ 14 डेज व्हिच इज दैट वन गेम दैट आई चूज टू रेस्ट माय आउटफील्ड प्लेयर्स बिकॉज़ सिंस यू आर द लोएस्ट रैंक टीम यू विल बी डूइंग द मैक्सिमम अमाउंट ऑफ रनिंग बिकॉज़ दैट इज योर बेस्ट चांस ऑफ यू नो गेटिंग समथिंग आउट ऑफ दैट गेम सो ही चोज द राइट गेम सो दैट द नेक्स्ट टू गेम्स he can maximize and get the maximum number of points. But mere ko ek cheez samajh mein nahi aayi. That is for the outfield players. Why would you rest a goalkeeper? A. Why would you rest a goalkeeper who is barely 21, 22? I don't know. I'm sorry if I don't know his age. And why would you rest a goalkeeper who's barely played any minutes in the ISL? So it's not like he's taking fatigue and getting it in. But why would he do that?
Brother, if you see, that's a decision taken by him. But what I feel is that, you know, first two match was a very good match from first time playing in such a big tournament and players giving their 100% best. But third match, we even though it was only 2-1, Goa lost 2-1, but we could see that they were much better than our side. And we could see that even after giving our 100% best, we know that it will be very, very difficult to win. And instead of going all out by the same 11, as he said that, you know, too many games in a very small day, in a very few days of time. So he chose to bring 5 changes and after even the goalkeeper. So I feel that, you know, in the next two matches, he will feel a different, the first same 11 that he have started for last two matches or three matches, in fact. So this is a decision. Same thing happened against when India played against UAE. Like we were talking against Oman, we played so well. And after that, we changed so many players and those players are not ready to play at this level. But I feel that even though these young players who came in yesterday, they're all good players playing in ISL. But we could see that it's not the same. They tried their best. They gave their best, but it was not good enough. And in maturity players, I think they need time to get matured to play this.
But Renedi bhai,
sorry
to jump in. I totally get your point on the outfield players of your resting players and you've given new players a chance. So, well, okay, great. I am just concerned, why did you rest your goalkeeper? Why?
Okay.
You know.
But if you talk about Dhiraj, right? Dhiraj, but yeah. India, I don't know, suddenly I think it's the media that, you know, we said, oh, Dhiraj. Now, if you see Dhiraj, the save that, of course, yes, I think he's playing much better than what he had played in ISL because Dhiraj started, he didn't play for a long time. At the first or three or four matches, it was very, very shaky. And it was not his best playing out from the back and Goa trying to play out from the back. But in last two matches, you know, he did some good saves. But that's all normal save. But then we say that, oh, Dhiraj played the best and this and that. But I think whatever he have done is that it's a normal save that he have done. So I feel that, you know, when you, instead of going, if he played last match and they lost 2-1, right? And if we had played, I think Dhiraj, yesterday's match, if Dhiraj would have played also, I don't think he will make big changes in there. So now, his mindset will be, 2-1. And yesterday, the other guy played and it is 4-0. So when he come again, his confidence will still be high. So just imagine, again, Dhiraj started playing well and two matches in a row, if he lose, then the next two games which we are going to play, it will not be the same again. So mental factor is there. But yesterday, even if Dhiraj would have played, I feel that result wouldn't change much. Maybe the first goal, yes, he could have saved.
But even the second one, Benedict, भाई, वो उसने गलती करी, उसको बचाने गया, उसको उड़ा दिया उसने पूरा वहाँ पे.
But what do you think about the goal that we concede on the third match against Persepolis, the second goal that we concede? A good penalty save from Dheeraj. What do you think about the save, about the goal that we concede? Do you think goalkeeper could have done better? Dheeraj could have done better?
Definitely.
In that match? Yes.
Definitely.
So you see the position. See the position where he was, you know, in the match that we lost 2-1. So goalkeeper, even this goalkeeper, he is coming back after a long time, and we could see that he was nervous. We could see
you could see he was really nervous.
You could see, yeah. So now, so it's, you know, we can talk and talk about this, but you know, I'm sure when Dheeraj come now, he will come with more confidence. His confidence will not be very low. Everyone will be thinking, saying that, oh, if Dheeraj would have played, things would have been different. But I don't think the goal would have been, you know, first goal. Other than that, I don't think it would have changed.
Jaideep sir, I'm not. So he's made the changes. I get that. I'm just saying that tomorrow night or last night when he were gone home, which would have been pretty late, by the way, because we were talking about this. We are a new father. Someone is a football coach who wakes up at 5 a.m. Renedy, bhai. You know, हम लोग एक सिर्फ हमारा एक नाइट बर्ड है हमारा दाली वाला भाई, बाकी सब 10:30 सोने वाले लोग हैं यहाँ पे. But so whenever he would have gone home at 1 a.m. or whatever, you think he would have thought and said कि maybe I made a mistake by keeping Dheeraj out. I get what Drendi bhai is trying to say and trying to keep him mentally fit and trying to keep that momentum going. You suppose he would have thought कि मैंने गलती करी Dheeraj के साथ यहाँ पे.
I think he was prepared for it. He was prepared for it. He just took a risk because, he knew the Persepolis will come out hounding. After a 2-1, somehow they will feel they will come out all guns blazing, and he knew that the Goa coach knew this is one match where Goa has the least chance. So he, I think, was prepared for it. So he took a risk by not playing Dheeraj, by playing Naveen. And
why would you rest your goalkeeper? I'm just asking you a simple thing. A 21-year-old keeper who's probably played 4 matches in the ISL.
Sorry to jump in. I know you're directing the question to Jerry, but firstly, I want to also apologize for having to force you guys to cancel the last show. But you know, given the scenario, the way things are, something came up and I unfortunately couldn't be around and hook it up. So sorry about that. And because of that, we didn't get a chance to talk about the last game actually. And that has what Jaideep was, I think, saying was that the 2-1 result, irrespective of what you might have heard from the press conferences, I think Persepolis took it as a little bit of an insult. I think the coach would have given his players a bit of a talking to after that result, because they did seem to be taking it very, very easy. You know, they were trying to be very too cute at times, you know, playing like Arsenal would play back in the day, where they keep passing the ball. But the finishing was lacking in that conviction. It seemed like they were very clearly playing against a schoolboy team. You know, and that attitude was like, yaar, hum bade player hai, hum maze karne aaye hain yahan pe. The way they were playing that in the air and back heels and this and that and all kinds of stuff. But the Dheeraj bit, yeah, Jaideep, isn't it baffling? I mean, don't you think that whatever the case, as a young goalkeeper, he would get much more benefit from playing in those tough situations where he's constantly going to have something to do rather than not?
Before sir answer, sir, could you remove your earphones? वो थोड़ा disturbance आ रहा है फिर से, जैसे आप पुराना करते थे हमारे साथ. Yeah.
Is it fine?
Yes, sir. हाँ जी, हाँ जी.
So, I think he took a calculated risk, and he didn't want to see 4 matches in a row under such humid condition. He made so many changes. He thought also, because again I am saying, he knew that Persepolis, he has no chance. He still has a chance, something against the other two teams. He might get 1 or 2 points from there. He might win a match also under these present circumstances. So he wanted his best players to stay as fit as possible. And Dheeraj is definitely one of his best players. The problem was Naveen Kumar he also knew that Navin Kumar hasn't got any much exposure in the ISL. He didn't get too many minutes to play, and he was thrown in front of the Wolves on the very first day. He was completely overwhelmed.
Like the Indian team versus UAE.
Yeah. So he was overwhelmed. Certainly, he was overwhelmed. And only thing that Dheeraj saved a penalty. Otherwise, it could have been 3-1. After 3-1, it could have been more also. You never know. And here he could not save it. So it was because that same fellow who missed the penalty the earlier day was very determined to score a goal. So I think after three matches and such humid condition, as you said, he may have some other reasons also. If we pinpoint on Dheeraj, he may not have showed all his cards to the while talking to the media. He may have some other reasons also, which we are not aware of course. So we have to go by what he says. So I think
more often than not, what is said in the media is not the reason.
I think what also what Venedi was bringing up earlier about the fact that after these couple of clean sheets, there's been a lot of talk in the press about Dheeraj and how well he's doing, etc., etc. And no doubt, being included in the match day squad for all of the AFC Champions League is a big thing for any young player, especially a young player from India. So full marks to Dheeraj, well done to him. But Jaideep also mentioned just now that the guy who missed the penalty, it was in equal parts a penalty missed and a save made. Because he hit the penalty, he took it very quickly. He hit it with power and he hit it straight down the middle at the goalkeeper. There was a little anticipation involved. I think 50% was luck, 50% was good goalkeeping. So perhaps this is also a way for the coach to keep his players' mentality in check.
That's what Andy is saying.
Yeah. So that seems to be the only thing, but I'm not sure if I agree with that logic, and maybe you guys don't either.
Mere bhai, you and I don't agree on a lot of things, but on this occasion, you and I are agreeing.
Yeah.
See, dekho ji, hum hai European Super League wale. If there is anyone who is flying the beacon of fairness and fair play and the way world football should be run, then it's Paris Saint-Germain people.
Even I don't agree. But this is what I feel that the coach decision has made the decision because of this of the what we are talking right now. That usko lagta hai ki Dheeraj khel ke bhi agar harega to it will affect his confidence. Uske liye usko khilaya gaya hai. But anyway, but if I was the coach, I think when you are having such two, three good matches, and I'll still play him because goalkeeper is a position where you cannot change all the time.
Exactly.
Because you have to, that's one position where you have to, you don't need too many changes. Yeah. But the thing is, and at the same time, everyone's talking about Dheeraj, he still have a long way to go. Whatever save he has made, it's all normal saves. It's nothing to do. But then we Indians, whenever we play, kisi ko Spider-Man bana deta hai, kisi ko ye bana deta hai, we still need to give time to that guy to prove. Yeah.
Renedi bhai, see, rest assured, hum charon ke beech mein, I think we all agree with you. That boy has a long way to go. There is no doubt about it. But and you said it right now, you're the coach. You've been there.
Yeah.
If there is one position you don't change, it's the goalkeeper.
It's goalkeeper. Yeah,
Agree. Then I'm adding more factors into it. A 21, 22-year-old keeper.
Yeah.
Then I'm adding more factors who's not played 70% of your ISL.
True.
Right? So if agar piche hi banda thoda hil raha hai, jo goalkeeper, jaise kal bich, I'm not saying Naveen is a bad goalkeeper. Don't get me wrong.
Yeah. Yeah.
But it's like Sir said, he was thrown to the wolves. See, what tells you if a goalkeeper is not confident? That he was jor-jor se apne teammates se baat nahi kar pa raha. Kal aapne dekha, he was barely talking to his teammates. That showed that the poor guy was, he was nervous. Aur jab haath kaanp rahe hote hain, fir to galtiyan honi hai goalkeeper se. So I don't get it. I feel that was a baffling call. But the rest, everything was fine. Because you're ready for the next two then.
Also, there's a question to anyone who might want to take it. Does it also kind of indicate from a coach's perspective that he is not so certain about who his number one is? That he's bringing Naveen in, giving him a chance in maybe in the hope that or there will be competition for that number one goalkeeper spot?
Yeah, so Siddharth, when he came in, when Dheeraj has not played for so many years, if Dheeraj was really, really good, he would have played many matches in Kerala. He would have played many matches in ATK. So, but anyway, he signed, when he got signed also, he didn't start at first few matches. He didn't start straight away. So Naveen was playing few matches, if you see. Yeah, first few matches. And after that, Dheeraj was not that great, because I can understand he didn't play for very long time, even though he has got all the talent, right? So goalkeeper, like we were talking about, goalkeeper needs time. So he has to play many matches as he can. But if you see the last three matches, the way he has played, I think he should be playing. The way he has played in last three matches, I think he should be playing. But that's a decision taken by the coach. So that's what I feel. But one good thing is now when he comes back. So now everyone is talking about Dheeraj Hone se ye game bacha deta tha. So he will have that confidence, you know. And that's a good thing that, you know, when he comes for these next two matches, Dheeraj will be playing with full confidence. So then one positive thing, yeah, it's there. So it will be good for the team, good for him.
Jaydeep sir, you know, hum patrakar log hai. At least aap aur Siddhant to hain. Hum to bak-bak karne wale insaan hain. Aur Renedi bhai hamare sath player hain. जो पत्रकार लोग होते हैं उनको ना ये चाबी मारने की, क्योंकि कुछ निकालना होता है तो एटलीस्ट यू नो आप ढूंढ रहे हैं क्या क्या है. वुड आई बी रॉन्ग और एम आई ओवरथिंकिंग इट दैट आफ्टर ऑल द प्रेज एंड हाइप दैट धीरज हैज गॉट एंड रेनेडी भाई इज अनदर वन हु अंडरस्टैंड्स द गेम एज वेल एज से वन फर्नांडो हु ऑल्सो पॉसिबली कुड बी ऑफ द सेम ओपिनियन दैट ही इज ओके यू नो यू कांट चढ़ाओ हिम लाइक स्पाइडरमैन दैट ही सेंट हिम अ मैसेज कि आप स्पाइडरमैन नहीं हैं, आपको जितना मीडिया चढ़ा रहा है चढ़ाने दो, बट दिस इज अ मैसेज ऑफ मी ब्रिंगिंग यू बैक डाउन टू अर्थ बाय मेकिंग यू सिट ऑन द बेंच. और एम आई रीडिंग टू मच इनटू इट?
आई डोंट थिंक सो. ही हैज बीन थिंकिंग टू दैट. व्हाट आई जस्ट ट्राइड टू से एट द टाइम दैट देयर मे बी सम अदर रीजन आल्सो. ही माइट हैव अ स्लाइट निगल, ही माइट हैव सम प्रॉब्लम. ठीक है, तू आज बैठ जा, ठीक है, क्योंकि आज तो जीतना नहीं है, ये गेम जीतना नहीं था. और ये ज्यादा से ज्यादा क्या होता, 3-0 ही होता, 4-0 नहीं होता तो 3-0 होता, ये तो होना ही था. और यू प्रिपेयर योरसेल्फ फॉर द नेक्स्ट टू मैचेस, एंड एज इट हैपेंस इन दिस मैचेस द वीकर टीम्स गोलकीपर इज द मोस्ट ओवरवर्क्ड पर्सन इन द ऑन द फील्ड, which has happened to Dheeraj in the last three matches, at least in a couple of matches, out of the three matches, in a couple of matches he had been. So perhaps he was given some rest so that he can come at his best in the next two matches. Because the problem in FC Goa's problem is FC Goa is not looking forward to anything. They are only looking forward to come up with some decent results and keep their flag flying to an extent, because they have no aim in front of them. They are not looking to finish top, which is out of question. They are not even looking to finish second. Even if they finish second with 2-3 points, they are not going anywhere, because the, I think, three second best team will go to the, apart from the 10 toppers, three second best team will go to the next round or whatever the year is. Mm-hmm. So FC Goa, it is for FC Goa, it is a matter of balancing act, that how to extract maximum power points out of it and keep up our decent show. So I think all these calculations had come to the coach's mind. So he wanted four or five of his best players to be rested for one day, so that they do better in the next two matches. And Dheeraj is, of course, one of the five best players, certainly, if he is not the best. As Renedi said, I would also add, like to say that Renedi is absolutely right. This is one thing was told to me. I would like to share one small thing with me. Once this thing was told to me by Bhaskar Ganguly. He's considered one of India's finest ever goalkeepers. He was India captain, 82 Asian Games, great player. He once told me, see, a lot of my matches against Iran, India lost 1-0 and he saved four or five, and he was lauded by the media and everything. He said, when you are in a weaker team, when there is a lot of pressure on you, then if you are good, then you are bound to come up with 2-3 saves, yeah. Good saves, which will make you a hero. He's saying that, not that I didn't do well, he told me, but more was made out of my performance than I actually made. I think Renedi also was trying to say the same thing.
Yeah, so, pretty much. I mean, the Spider-Man reference is from the 2011 Asian Cup. When the press had given that or title or name.
Subrata Paul.
Because he, against Australia, against South Korea, he was making 10 saves a game because that's how it was, you know. And even though we were conceding, we conceded 4 goals in each of those matches, if I'm not wrong, Renedi.
One was 5, I think. I don't know. Whatever. But he really, really played very well and saved a lot of time.
So the question I was going to ask very quickly is that if your players need it, then your perspective is that maybe against Al Rayyan, less so maybe Al Wahda, you think that you might be able to get a positive result. And when I say positive result, I mean a win, right? That's what you're planning for. That's why you're resting your key players. In that case, Ivan Gonzalez and Donaghy, aren't they your most key players and don't they deserve the rest more than anyone else?
Because he has 4 foreigners in the team. He has to play. And that would have been disastrous to not to play these 2 foreigners. Right? Sorry, Renedi, please go on.
The thing is, without Juan Gonzalez, yesterday the result would have been 7 or 8, right? So we saw that, I respect a lot. If Indian players are doing well, I'm happy. But in this type of games, without those 2 players, you may not have the best striker, but you have to have a good foreign, defender to defend. Without them, it's very, very difficult. But I must say that yesterday, last 5-10 minutes, when Martins came on, when Ortiz came on, when our Indian player, the midfielder,
Brandon.
So the game looks better. That was a very mature play that they played, which we couldn't see for first 75-80 minutes. So when they came on, the game looked different. Even though we are losing, whenever we are holding the ball or whenever we are passing the ball, it looks much better than the first 70 minutes. But all due respect to all the youngsters, they were traveling in 100 kilometers per hour in every, in everything they do is like hard body. But football, it's not. We need to know when to attack, when to defend, when is the right time. Because in this type of match, we cannot just match them. We were trying to match them. So now, for Persepolis, the players were traveling so fast with the ball, without the ball. We were trying to match them. But we know that. But those players who came on in the last 5-10 minutes, they know when to and when not to. So this is the difference. That our Indian players who have played, they are not bad. They're tough fit. But it's not about tough fit. It's about more matches, It's about the experience that we saw in the last 10 minutes.
Randy bhai ne muh se baat chheen li. But before I move on to the next topic, by the way, if you take a look at Siddhant and see his name, it's Perez. So, aap dekh sakte na, that is the garden in India, jahan pe European Super League ka plan hatch hua hai. So, Perez in disguise. That's Perez in disguise. He's trying to get away from the media in Europe.
Yes, sir.
Florentino. Hi, Florentino. Que pasa?
Huh? What we are trying to do is we are trying to overthrow the European power structure completely.
But before that, you have to do AIFF na first. So, pehle aap unko hatao. Fir aap European structure hataoge, bhai.
To uske bare mein ek... Bhai, hum mein chota mota sochte hi nahi hai. Seedha top pe ja.
Yeah. Lo ji. Theek hai, bhai. But I'll tell you why Renedi bhai ne muh se baat chheen li. The way Glenn Martens has been playing, the way Glenn Martens came and steadied the midfield as soon as he came, even if it was for 10 minutes or 15 minutes. And this question is open to all. The next time your Indian camp is out, if that boy is not part of your Indian camp, it would be, what is the word? Can I say criminal? It would be criminal to not have that boy in the camp. Just absolute the amount of composure he shows in the middle of the park. He knows when to get the ball, knows when to release the ball. He can put in a tackle. And the beauty of that boy, you know, jo hadbadi wala player hota na, wo har jagah bhagta hai. Pat, 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 pat. Usko pata hai kitna bhagna hai, kitni jagah bhagna hai, kitna rehna hai. Ye uski sabse khas baat hai. Jaideep sir, does he walk into the playing 11 for you, for India? Main to camp se aage ja raha hu. So, because mere ko to chahiye wo waisa ladka hai beech mein. Kaun hai aapka beech mein abhi khelne wala? Jo waisa khel raha hai.
I think he will be called in the camp and kept in the team also. But whether in the first 11, that depends on the match, which match they are.
But the way we set up, have someone who can hold the ball and then make that extra 1-2 passes, that will really help the team.
Yeah. He is definitely a deserving boy in the national team. But starting 11, though, it changes from time to time. So it is not very easy to say. And especially when we have a coach who has used 38 players in 12 matches. Because it's not Bob Hutton. It's not Bob Hutton. Bob Hutton, the first 11, we all know.
Yeah.
We all know. The only thing he might change, he might say, maybe Clifford in place of Renetti in the second half. That was used to be his, maybe once in a while. But otherwise, his first 11 used to be the same. We knew who were going to play there. So, but this is one coach whose most unpredictable area is his first 11. So there, when you put this question, why Glenn Martin, you bring anybody, even Baichung Bhutia or I am Vijayan from the past, I won't be able to say it straight away that they will be in the first 11.
He's not making a case for himself. I'm just saying the quality he has.
Brother, I feel that the game that he played the last few matches, he should be. And we need a player like him. I know Jackson.
Yeah.
I know Jackson.
We need a player like him. Exactly.
They started in the middle of the park last time. But Glenn, we need a player like him. Of course, yes, he has to gel. Glenn Martin has played really well. Gelling is a problem, but I feel.
You.
Okay.
I'll flip it a little more. So generally, when you see Indian team playing opposition of this quality, and then what you've seen FC Goa playing opposition of this quality, and FC Goa is mostly Indians, one player here and there, right? I felt FC Goa looked a lot more composed with those Indian boys. They held the ball, they moved the ball in the very small spaces of time that they had in the game. Yes, that improved when Glenn and Brandon came in, two Indian players again. So, in the sense, they didn't let go of their philosophy. I think that's the biggest positive, right? Ki bhai, wo train aagi hai hamare samne Rajdhani wali, to hum to ji phadak, maar do ji Punjab wali football. They still kept the ball. They still passed it out to a guy who had pressure on him or had a Persepolis guy on him on a yard or two. And I think that, for me, was the best thing to watch.
Yeah, certainly. From the very first match, they have been able to maintain his shape. After 60th minute yesterday, Persepolis was relaxed. There was no doubt about it. Last half an hour, they didn't. They just played like that. Oh, it's okay. But even first 60 minutes, when they are pressing a lot, especially in the second half, early second half, they at least Goa were able to maintain a shape. And the previous two matches, they were. That's a big credit. And I think the biggest reason for that. The Goa coaching staff, Goa team, Goa players, they did their homework very well. They had no qualms about the quality of their opposition, how better they are. They knew about it. They knew everything. But they still managed to keep the shape well because they did their homework very well. Before they came out on the field, they knew what they are going to do, which is very evident from the game. Anybody can see it. All of us can see it. Otherwise, you don't produce such a, I won't say it's a clinical display, I won't say. But given all the limitations and one foreigner less, given all the limitations and having to play with four foreigners, which they haven't done done throughout the season, and still they managed to keep the shape up, and against formidable teams which are much better than the opponents who find in the ISL, it's a huge credit, I would say, to the coach, to the coaching staff, and to the players. And with this kind of weather, the weather was not at all favorable. It's true. Very humid. It's very hot. If the weather had been of, say, December or January, it could have been a little better. But here, it was very difficult. I think they did a good job.
Raghavendra Perez, sir?
Huh?
That's his alias. He's hiding over here, no? Raghavendra Perez.
That means, again, I am saying, which I said in my previous program also, that means with planning, you can do it. At this level, with little more planning, you can do it. But if your planning is faulty, then what happens? We have seen. I don't want to repeat again and again the same thing.
Yeah, Annie.
No, I was going to say, I mean, I think any comparisons in terms of how the performance of the two clubs, these two clubs, is a bit unfair, because as it happens in the Champions League, even in Europe, most of the people, I think, watching our show as well as us are more familiar with the European Champions League than we are with Asian clubs and the Asian Champions League. So when a Manchester United or a Paris Saint-Germain or a Real Madrid play against, you know, some of the clubs from much smaller leagues, whether it's Ireland or some country like that, who have managed to come to qualifying rounds and make it through to the main draw, you see the clear difference in the standard of football. On the one hand, in this case, you have Iranian players who are, in theory, a World Cup level squad. Mm. Right? Many of them play for Team Melli, some were part of the FIFA World Cup team that went to Russia in 2018. So the standard, and we, on the other hand, are still fighting to qualify for the Asian Cup continental competition, right? Even this direct entry into the Champions League is only because the competition has been expanded and therefore we've been given a slot. If we were to go through qualifying rounds, maybe FC Goa would not even be in this competition at all. So that has that perspective we cannot forget. Given that, I think I'm in agreement with Jaideep on what he said about how well-drilled this squad is. Barcelona se main nahi aaya hu, Barcelona se aaye to Mr. Juan Ferrando hai asal mein. Aur wo, you know, because of injuries as a player and all that.
Barcelona se aaya, he's got Barcelona connections.
As in, like, he's the city of Barcelona, not the club.
Achha, he's born in Barcelona, okay.
And he's been coaching football from the age of 18. So whatever he's good at, not good at, whether you agree with his tactics and his decision-making and his playing 11 or not, the fact is that for a majority of his life, he has looked at football from the perspective of a coach. So he's obviously very, very well versed with it takes to prepare a team to approach a competition, to approach an opposition side. And that has been evident. And I think the players have... it seems to be that there's a vibe that's working out, because the players are taking on board all of the information they're getting, all of the preparation they're getting, and they're being able to execute. You can't expect them to be if they take 11 guys like us and give us the best coach in the world, there's no way we can go and compete against, the best players, even without a coach.
We can at least win media five-a-side.
Yeah, we might be able to, yes. In that sense, in terms of, like apples and oranges ka comparison nahi kar sakte hai. But for what it is, I think the performances have been encouraging. I also disagree with, even if Dheeraj had been in goal and had conceded four goals, I don't think it would have been a dent to his confidence, because he would have gotten
90 more minutes, man.
Gotten 90 more minutes under his belt. And it would have only been a further boost, because whatever else would have happened, he would have pulled off 2, 3, 4 good quality, decent saves, and felt like he's a part of the squad that's going forward also into the next season, into the next matches, whatever the case might be. And like you guys have all been saying, the goalkeeper is critical. So having that guy as a regular, able to marshal and monitor his defensive line, able to communicate with the players, able to help, you know, small things like distribution make a huge difference, right? For a team that's likely to play on the counter attack, even against Al Wada, Al Rayyan, if you bring Dheeraj into play as a kind of a distribution angle, like Edu Bedia himself is playing so deep, you also have Dheeraj who, if he has more and more match practice of playing those balls out to free players and perhaps getting breaks started, fast breaks, transition, counter attacks, whatever you want to call them, it'll only help him grow as a player and it'll only help the team in the long run.
But here is why I like this Goan team, because for long, and we've harped on it as well, that when you're playing a team that is of a higher level, of a higher quality in every aspect of the game, if an Indian team has to go out there and compete, then you have to play counter-attacking football. Agreed. Because, you know, we've seen that with the national team who continue to play that. But for me, what they have shown is that that is not the only way to play. Because if you see parts of their game, and you see parts of their full strength team, they pass, they pass, they pass. They do a lot of passing in their own half. And so white, you might think, yaar, aage kyun nahi pass karna? Main bhi jab match kabhi TV pe dekhta, maine kaha, aage dekh. But wo piche piche isle karte hain, because you're sucking out the opposition. And then that one pass is hit in through the lines and you have one guy moving, you have one more guy moving. And so you have, it's not ki bas uda diya ji, wahan pe Mars ke liye maine ball aur bhago ji yahan pe usko lekar.
Yeah, so, particularly because they have so many of these young players who have a lot of pace. So,
that's the thing. But the thing is, they have belief in their sense to hold the ball. They have belief that if a defender or an opposing player is near me, I can still, you know, cut back. I can still move left. I can still move right. I can still try finding someone who's closer to me for an option. Totally. Right? Their last resort is banging it up.
Yeah,
that was really nice to see.
I completely agree with you and appreciate that. They're like, you know, when you start banging the ball up the pitch, there are, I think, two factors in it. One is that you are very tired. So the fact that these boys are still able to continuously, despite being under pressure for all 90 minutes, they are still able to play with the ball.
Yeah,
the
pitch.
It means that they are extremely well conditioned. So I think that is something that we all agree on. But the second thing is that they are not afraid of what the result might look like, sound like, how the media will react to it, etc. They're out to see if they can execute things and at what level they can execute at.
And when stay true to what they play, basically.
Yeah,
stay
when you're playing for the national team, I think another perspective that comes in is that, yaar, agar hum 8 goals, 10 goals se haar gaye, you know, hum pure desh ko represent kar rahe hain, pure desh ki media baat karegi, sare fans dekh rahe hain hume. Abhi, filhal to, I mean, FC Goa are in a similar situation. And indeed, the backs of their jerseys say India. You know, because they are the club that's representing the nation in this competition, no doubt. But they are still not the national team. There are foreign players involved in this squad and there are other things. It's a private team. So, they have shown that they are not afraid to at least play as best as they can, irrespective of what might happen in terms of the final scoreline or the statistics, which is very, very encouraging. And it's very important for all teams to try and do this because it's the only way we're going to kind of get, apart from the development angle, it's the only way we're going to actually get better at playing the game.
Yeah.
And also enjoy watching it.
True. Jaydeep sir, moving a little more forward, Ishan Pandita, right? And I think it's a valid distinction because if he's part of your scheme for the Indian team going forward, he's somewhere being called the new kid on the block or the boy wonder, but then kya kya. From whatever I've seen in these 3 or 4 games where the coach has given him the full 90, I could understand why the coach did not start him more in the ISL. I sort of got a sense of why the coach did not start him more in the ISL. I get that you're playing against opposition that is way ahead of you. So you are on the back foot. And you're playing as the lone striker. So you're more on the back foot. Aap khali ho wahan pe. Matlab aapke aas pas do defender to hone hi hai jab bhi aapko ball milni hai. But even then, there are certain qualities that come out and tell you, does this guy have that striking ability? And I'll tell you why it came to my head. It's because when that boy Chote came into play from Manipur, who's come in from Minerva, that boy looked good, sir. He knew when to move. He knew where to move. He knew how to take the ball. He won a few headers, even though he's small in height. And that was really impressive. While Ishan Pandita just comes across so far. Please don't get, don't take it the wrong way. Bas bhaag raha hai. Hitting a few, falling down. Bhaag raha hai. Hitting a few, falling down. One touch here, doing that. Am I zyada pad raha hun usme? He's a work in progress for sure. He is a work in progress. But I'm just getting back to the point that Anuj said, that a boy who's played as a midfielder all throughout his life, isko time lagega agar if he's going to play in that focal point for the team.
Time to lagega jarur, and one striker mein aise bhi India ko chalta nahi hai. If you look at it, one striker in an Indian team and back to as an Indian as a striker, it never really works. I have seen. See, I'm not undermining anybody's ability, but wo hota nahi hai, for whatever reasons, I don't know. So, you are right to an extent that which you did not say, which you, I think, wanted to say, that he looked out of depth.
Yes, time. Yes.
Which is definitely true. But again, extremely formidable opponents. Most of the time you are busy defending. Yeah. Your ball is playing in your half only. And there is very little chance of getting too many through passes, intelligent through passes. So all this put together, I think Ishan Pandita has not stood out at all, except in the first match. First match, he was not bad, I would say. Mm-hmm. And after that, he didn't look bad. He looked helpless, I thought. Which I felt if he looked out of depth, that is because of helplessness. Because they had nothing more to do than to defend, more or less defend. So maybe a foreign striker like that boy who scored a lot of goals in the ISL, what was his, I forgot,
Angulo
could have looked more fitting in that place, but since you are playing with four foreigners, you have to take this.
I'm just saying why, because here's my thing. The word I was looking for, he didn't come across as being involved in the game when the team was attacking. That's my point. The time when that Chote boy came, Persepolis, if they were playing on the fifth gear, they'd come down to third gear in those last 15-20 minutes of the game. So yes, okay, maybe he's got a little more freedom and space and time. But for whatever amounts he played, he seemed a lot more involved in the game. Right? It wasn't just that jo aage hamara khada hai, usne ji wo aise on kiya aur bole ji chur bhago. You know? It seemed he was a lot more involved.
But Pandit also, like the observation that you were making earlier, that later on in the game when Ortiz came on and Martins came on and all of these guys came on, the whole kind of way that Goa were playing was a bit different. And
no, but I'm taking all games into account. I'm not just talking about yesterday. I'm taking games into account.
I honestly, I haven't seen enough of Makhan.
I'm saying all games into account of full strength team, B strength team, whatever.
Yeah.
I'm just saying that I think four games is a good sample size. To 4 games of 90 minutes each is a good sample size to tell you a bit about a player. And I'm not expecting him to score a goal. I'm not expecting him to get a player, do step overs and cut and score a goal.
No.
I'm just saying I haven't seen him that involved in the attack of the team. For someone who's your focal striker, Pandita.
Pandita, right?
Yeah.
So,
and involvement is not involvement doesn't mean I have to do the highest level of things or the best things. Involvement means you're involved in the attack. You're part of that puzzle that's going up.
Yeah, sure. And I think his role has been defined as the guy who has to do the running around without the ball, without any friends around him.
Exactly.
That lonely job for most of it. And as far as the comparison with Chote is concerned, as far as this competition, if we're talking about, Devendra Murgaonkar has been brought on as a sub in the first three games, right? So, or in the third game, perhaps he started. I'm not sure.
He started last game also.
He started this game for sure.
Yeah.
So Chote coming in, I'm not really able to comment much on because I haven't seen him. But the other player who I did think even in the first half did well was Radim Tilang. I thought he again demonstrated.
Okay, so basically the UEFA and FIFA have caught up with Florentino Perez and they've frozen his Wi-Fi. Jaideep sir, any other players who have caught your eye? Or can not, I take it forward? Can I take it forward? I'll take it a little forward. What are you expecting versus Vahda and Ryan? Realistically, what are you expecting?
I expect maybe some people might say it is, I'm expecting too much. But I'm expecting them to go to the next level.
Oh, you are?
And somehow manage 3 points from one of the matches.
So you think they can qualify?
My expectations. I am not saying they will do it, which I also doubt a lot. If you ask me one, and then I'll scratch my head that how much I believe in it. But I will expect them to go to the next round because this is one thing which I have seen enough, or rather we have seen enough. I can give you 30 incidents in the last 30 years where Indian teams, whether it is a club team or the national team or a junior team, has suddenly done very well. They have beaten UAE or under-19. They have beaten Argentina or Dempo has reached semifinals of AFC Cup and all these things have happened. But it is all those things are one-time wonder I have found. Every time we think, something is happening in Indian football. But we know this is this. Then we realize that it's only a temporary thing. So to make it permanent, to make it more impactful, to make it something which will help the game in the country to come up, to do better. So FC Goa have to step into the next level. For not FC Goa. Anybody who are playing at that level from India, representing India at that level, I would expect them to go to the next level. Whether it will happen or not, that's a completely different issue. So many practical things are involved in it. But as you said, what we expect. So I would expect to do better.
So it's like you expecting us to start on time, but the story is very different. expectation and reality is a very different situation. Fam, it's doable from what we've seen. Vada and Ryan, you know, what would they need realistically? They need a win and a draw, or they can do that in two draws and move ahead. What is the
two draws to make it finish as one of the best placed second teams?
Yes,
there's still a lot of games to be played. Yes.
Two teams go through, or one team goes through.
One team goes through.
One team goes through.
Because the tournament is divided into two halves to begin with, the groups, right? The Eastern Conference and the Western Conference. It's not called that. I'm just.
If you had your way, you would have changed everything in world football, European football, Maldivian football.
I'm going to change my name also. Meeta Perez Modi Patel.
Yeah, in a part. Haan ji, sir.
Ab ja ke aayega impact. Anyway, so on the one side, the strong teams are, as we expect, the teams from the Chinese Super League. Haven't done so much at the Champions League level yet, but are starting to make an impact. And the Chinese League is now rated the number one league in Asia in terms of the standard of the competition. And then you have Korea and those countries. Then on this side, on our side where we are,
West.
Yeah. You have Iran, Iraq, obviously UAE, Saudi, all these countries. So, the top team goes through. The second phase of the Eastern phase of the competition will only happen 2 months later. So really speculating on who the best second place finishers are at this point is absolutely meaningless and it's completely hypothetical because that competition hasn't even begun yet. So we have really no idea what's going to happen. even as far as these matches are concerned, now Goa, there's still enough to sort of go in terms of all the other groups as well for us to be able to really say how the math will work out. Two wins, I would say 100%. Okay,
so how many points are you expecting of six? How many points are you expecting out of six?
See, I think that Goa have gotten 2 points already. Has put
his job done.
In terms
it's
of
job done for me. For me, job done.
Yeah. If they can get one more point, whether that's through a win and a loss, or I mean, a draw and a loss, or if they can get two more draws, that's brilliant, I think. To be able to show that you can go out and two matches in a row against a club from Qatar, against a club from the UAE, and get two draws, I think it's not great, but there's progress. Definitely no negatives that can be taken from that. And then if you put yourself in that position right at the end, you know, maybe 80 minutes into the last game, mistakes can happen, chances come. I think Goa have quality players. They do have the kind of quality, like you saw that one-off shot from Ortiz,
yeah.
Yeah.
At the end.
The only work that the Persepolis goalkeeper had to do in the entire 95 or so minutes. And not a very challenging save. It was still not top corner by any means, or bottom corner or anything. And the keepers have these days away at also high definition cameras. So when you fly through the air, everything looks like, whoa, what a save. It was a save that from 35 yards out, any goalkeeper of this quality would make that save. But, you know, these things, mistakes can happen. 90 minutes, goalkeeper's not doing anything. Suddenly, out of the blue, one long-range effort, concentration is off, and it's a goal, and that's that. So I think they will take heart from this and know that they are still in with some sort of chance. But progression is a bit far-fetched.
Progression is a bit far-fetched. I kind of agree with you. And Sir also said the same thing. Expectation, Alexis Oti, but realistically, of course, progression is a bit too far-fetched. 3 points, you're saying, I think Mirle, the job is already done. Ab to jo bhi hoga is a cherry on the cake. Ki bhai, you know, maze le lo. Do mukablon ke bhai, ye aapko enjoy karne ke liye hain. Enjoy the fact that you have an Indian team that's playing there. Enjoy the fact that you have an Indian team that's staying true to their philosophy. And they're keeping the ball down. Playing against higher quality opposition. So, you know, so that is great to watch.
I think they'll have a head start compared to the other teams, whenever the next season of the ISL comes around, they'll already be used to playing this system with one less foreigner, you know, and more confidence.
Oh yeah, that's a good point.
More confidence in their young Indian players. I think the respect that some of the imports will have for the local talent will go up.
Yeah, that's another good point.
Tons of positives, I think.
Tons of positives. Okay, so we had decided that all our Champions League shows on FC Goa will be hard-timed. 3 to 4. We're not going to be dragging it. It's 3:58. Now what we're going to do is we're going to come after the next game. When is the next game? On Monday, right? Monday night is the next game. That means Tuesday afternoon at 3 p.m. we're coming your way. The crew can keep on changing, but we'll have a minimum of 3 to 4 people here. To have an interesting and engaging conversation. Just a reminder to everyone ki we're on Instagram. Do follow us at 420grams. Do give us a subscribe on YouTube, 420grams. Do give us a subscribe on, or do give us a follow on Twitter @420_grams. This is where we put out our stuff. And apologies for not coming the last time, but look, bahar jo mahol hai na bhai, it's impacting everyone. And it's impacting people on the crew over here as well. So it's better that sometimes some things are way bigger than football and talking about football. These are very small things that we're doing here. In a sense, our passion is. So that's why we're talking. And that's why we're talking so much with our hearts. So don't think bad about it. If you haven't come to the show, there are a lot of things happening in the world to get angry over rather than 3 or 4 people who are sitting here talking about football.
I think I can appreciate, you know, we are all dealing or interacting with people who have COVID these days. I don't think there's almost any household in the entire country which is not somehow affected. So there are differing perspectives on it, of course, but one of the key things, and this is mostly in the context of the IPL that's going on, that people are looking at it as a valuable distraction. So I yeah. think people look at us also as a valuable, or not valuable, but a distraction, nevertheless. So you know, जब बाहर इतनी सारी चीजें चल रही होती हैं, ये कोई इलाज नहीं है, कोई दवा नहीं है, लेकिन थोड़ा सा एक ब्रेक है सिर्फ from the reality of what's going on outside. So people take it, I think, quite personally when we go missing, and that's fair enough. I think जितना आप ज़्यादा गाली हमें खिलाएंगे, unlike the सरकार, जहाँ पे ये हिसाब किताब नहीं है, हमें मालूम है कि जब हम आप हमें गाली देते हैं तो वो सिर्फ प्यार से देते हैं. But also this little Perez PSG thing that we have going on, there's a point to it, and the point is that this is a teaser to a show that we need to do.
दिल्ली में बैठ के कहाँ हम यूरोपियन सुपर लीग की बात करेंगे यार.
अरे सर, आप क्या बात कर रहे हो? आप दिल्ली में बैठ के अगर जर्सी पहन सकते हो तो आप बात क्यों नहीं कर सकते?
सर, जर्सी तो 350 रुपए की मिलती है, हम तो ले लेते हैं, उसमें क्या बड़ी बात है. बट जयदी सर, जाते जाते आपको कुछ कहना है, टिप्पणियां बिफोर वी से गुड बाय टू एवरीवन? हाँ, क्लोजिंग कॉमेंट सर.
I would say we will be invaluable distraction in the next game.
Kya baat hai. Theek hai. Jaydeep sir, Siddhant, thank you so much for your time. And much love to Renedy bhai who joined us while on a car trip. So bhai, ye dekho pyaar. Friend of the show, aise nahi bulate hum Renedy and Ishwak ko.
And please, please send your love to Ishwak also, who is not well. And Jaydeep, who is currently recovering and has
here for... How are you feeling now, sir?
Much better. I am much better. Hopefully on the way to recovery, that much I can say.
Perfect. Love to hear. Chalo, great. Yeah, bhai, Jaydeep sir ki daad deni padegi. Even though he's not been well, he's been joining us for every show. So sir, much love to you and much love to all of you who joined, bhai. I hope your families, your close ones, you guys are all fine. And we'll be back after the next SC Goa game. Same time, 3 p.m. to 4 p.m. is when we'll be chatting on 420 grams. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye.
Bye-bye. हो गया,
आई थिंक वी आर लाइव. एक मिनट, आई थिंक यू कैन लीव. ही इज हंग. सिद्धांत का फ्रीज हो गया. आई थिंक वी स्टिल लाइव दैट्स व्हाई. हाँ.